Niger people, good morning. It's been a while, huh? Haven't dropped a video in a long time. How na day? Anything that happened? I don't say. Before we begin, when did you last recite the pledge, the Nigerian pledge? I pledge to Nigeria, my country, to be faithful, loyal, and honest. When did you last recite the pledge? Do you still love Nigeria? Do you still love Nigeria, your only country, your beloved nation? Abi, it's all about you, yourself, how much you can steal, how much you can loot only for you and your family. You have no better idea. You can't come up with a credible, tangible idea. The only idea you can come up is how to, like, how to steal, how to rob, how to abuse power, which is very rampant in Nigeria now. How to abuse power, the power that was handed over to you, the power that was handed to you by the people to use to save them. The people gave you power to speak on their behalf. What have you been doing with that power? You've been using it to punish, to oppress the same people who believed in you. Though not all of them believed in you. Some of you, you stole your way to power. But those of you who were appointed, who were legally elected by your people, because your people trusted you, because they've been reciting their pledge, the Nigerian pledge, and singing the Nigerian national anthem for years, they're still waiting and hoping that one day a true Messiah will show up to deliver them out of their bondage, out of the wahala, the misery in which they themselves put themselves into, their children put them into. Waiting you they do with that power. You they use them, they abuse the same people are be. So now I make ask you, when did you last recite the pledge? I pledge to Nigeria, my country, to be faithful, loyal, and honest, to save Nigeria with all my strength. When did you last recite that? Unity, faith, and progress have been IMP, our coat of arm. Unity, faith, and I'm not sure. But does it really matter? It really matter. Does it really matter? That unity, faith, and progress, that pledge, the national anthem, it really matter? Nigeria, our country, yo. Ah, generation, our culture. Omeka boy, shout out to Omeka boy. How many of you now don't listen to that generation, that this thing? Power where they give you to use, save people, use, help people, use, bring development to your communities. See, the development no mean destroy your culture, destroy your people, destroy your way of life. No, development, it means waiting, it means development. Developing means progress. They develop on your ideas. You get idea already for your head. Develop on that idea, work on that idea, use that idea to improve people's life or something. Use that idea to improve the state of something. They can talk and like that. Make you know, be like, say, I go come here, begin to bite my tongue. You know, as I do for a podcast from Funny, so I could sit on there, they speak like, say, I speak bad English. Just to hype, like to the spike some people's mind your business spirit up. you know, you know how you could do some things to spice some people up, you know, people where no fit respect themselves, people who can't mind their business, people who can't seem to mind their business. You could say things to this, you know, to incite them, to spark them up, make them yarn. Because remember, say that time when we were small, then say we learn to learn by learning. You learn to speak by speaking. You see? So when you spark them like that, they will come online and start spewing their hatred. You know, from there you could learn. You could learn. See. You see this world where we live. Get people where they're super smart too. I'm telling you, one of those people now, this guy, this handsome man, where you see so. If it acts stupid, if it act a fool, you could think, say, I'd be fool. But you don't know, say, I'd learn. Now, waiting, we are learning from my late dad with that. So, you see, our country, Nigeria, may we join hand. May we join hand, see how we fit improve our Nigeria. Don't be your problem, oh. You, where they work out, they do like say, Nigeria problem, now nah, your problem. You they do like say the problem where Niger get now nah, you cause them. No be you cause them all. It could be collective effort. Everybody could come together. Everybody could understand. Everybody could come to an agreement, to an understanding. Say, we all, Oyibo carve us or put inside that geographical land where them call Bongo. Say now we all could put our differences aside. Say now we all could put our greediness aside. Say now we all could put our jealousy, our backbiting. Now we all could put our fucked up attitudes aside and come together to build and to correct that country. Because that country, the way where that country day now, the country needs serious correction. The country supposed go to one kind correctional facility. I know say, you where they scream, you where they wreck, you where they jarret, say people where they government, no send you, no care about you. I know, say, you are training and grooming your own children to one day become leaders. Allegedly, you are grooming your own children on how to manage economy, how to manage things. Some of una they groom those una children on how to loot, how to steal, how to plunder, how to how to siphon, how to cheat. No be waiting. See, if we all they do like that, say everybody wants to be permanent secretary. Nobody wants to learn handwork again. Because see, if you come to this country where I live so, now production, manufacturing, now be the powerhouse of Germany. Do I need to stress any further? How many of una no know Mercedes-Benz? How many of una no know BMW? How many of una no know Audi? How many of una no know Volkswagen? How many of una no know Cupra? How many of una no know Porsche? How many of una no know make her continue? How many of una no know ThyssenKrupp? How many of una no know all the most of the see all the companies where been they build good roads in Nigeria at that time, them Strabag, them Julius Berger, them Heidkamp. These are German companies. Make her begin, make her continue. So now, and the people where they work in people where they do those things, people who are constructing, manufacturing, assembling, designing those vehicles, them be trade with these the people where go learn apprenticeship. You see, when I came to this country, I don't get HND, get all those degrees, won't I get? But when I landed in this country, my brothers, my sister, I had to go to an apprenticeship. I had to go for all the, for an apprenticeship course. I had to go do another 4 years. Here they call it us building. But it gets some way they call vital building, fourth building. Those ones, they a little advanced and shit. Even if you be graduate for your country, you come to this place. If you're smart, you use that, you're this thing, go back, go to the, go, let them retrain you. Some people will come and do shulung. Let them retrain you. Because my brothers and sisters, our education, waiting them, they teach us for Nigeria, then they prepare us to go carry file for office. We no get, our trade schools, them don't die off. Our trade school, them, all of them don't work. The technical schools, that time, those days, in the 80s, technical school. If you send your pikin go to technical school in Nigeria, in those days, my brother, your pikin now, you know, if your pikin say in the co-polytechnic, in those days, they've been the respect polytechnic students, past university students. Now, liar talk. In those days, they've been the respect technical school students, technicians, past or ordinary secondary school, college students. Now, liar talk. If you, from the 70s, 80s, stand the fuck up. Am I lying? Technical school. Me, I've been go technical school. I go government. I attended government vocational training school. Hey, wait. Now there I learn how to fix cars. Come on, man. Now there I learn how to fix cars. Because we've been they do trade work. We've been they do apprenticeship. From there, I can't enter government technical college. Come go enter government technical college. My brain was so, from there, I can't go polytechnic. But my brothers and sisters, see. The only way where your economy, the only way where your economy fit improve, now manufacturing, production. When we look at China now, then they carry fire, then they produce phones. Then come these Western countries, come the lane, then come do apprenticeships here. Carry that idea, go back to China. Now everybody is manufacturing things in their kitchen, waiting. All of us, they think for Niger, we all want to be permanent secretary, assistant secretary to this person. So we won't go for no steal money. No better idea. Nobody, the people will get better idea. If person get better idea, produce one thing. Inko makes more money. The next thing we Inko think of, now to jackpot from the country. Why? Because he no go get any support from the government. So I know they blame those people. When they produce something, invent small thing, people go support them online. Them go gather small money, the next thing, not to jackpot. And once them jackpot, the idea don't die. Because once you land in this country, you can't start from square one. Once you come land this Obodo Yibo, you're starting from square one, from level zero. So if you know they well disciplined, if you know they determined, you know go follow that your dream where follow carry you come here. Telling una the gospel truth, our government suppose sit the fuck right. Them suppose sit upright. Them suppose sit up, faced up to the tax where they in front of their face, where they under their noses. We have talented people in Nigeria. Revamped our technical colleges, for Christ's sake, teach, introduce apprenticeship programs in Nigeria. Our universities know they teach us anything good. Them they teach us how to, them they prepare our children on how to go work in England. What the hell? Any student, every student will graduate. After graduation, them do their NYSC. What next? Them won't go work for one oil company. Their hope and dream now to join one corporation. All their hope and dream now to travel, to run out of the country, go some foreign country, come continue, go do MBA, BSc, spend another 10 years. If you train, if you do apprenticeship, learn something, learn how to produce something. That those 10 years where you won't go waste, go get paper where no go benefit you in any way, other than to give you small money where you could use pay bills. Where you could use pay bills. Come on, people. Come on, people. The people where the person where invented this social media where you they use, watch me. Them no been get PhD, MSc, full house. Those years where you go waste, they study things where no go benefit you in any way. Now just simple because you want to keep the paper for your wall. So that one day, person go say, yeah, that, hey, yeah, that's Mr. You know how we like to do things like that. I am Mr. This, PhD, MSc, BSc. Waiting you get, waiting your PhD gets. We get PhD holders, full Nigeria electricity, no day. None of una fit come up with any invention or any innovation. Say, hey, how we fit harness the power of the sun. We live on the equator. We live almost on the equator. How we fit harness the power of the elements. But we get PhD full everywhere. We get MBA full everywhere. We get doctors full everywhere. People are dying of curable diseases. People are dying of malaria. People are dying of headache, common fever, common flu. But we get doctors full everywhere. We they send our children abroad to go train how to become doctors, to go train to become doctors. But people are dying of ear infections in Nigeria. We no fit use the plant where they our bush. Synthesize things. We no fit synthesize the plants where full our forests. But we call ourselves doctors. We call ourselves PhD. Next time you want to recite the national pledge, make you shut the fuck up and sit down. If you no respect Nigeria, because most of una no know say una they very disrespectful to that our beloved country. But every time you could say I pledge to Nigeria my country, you could sing the national anthem. You understand what you sing. See, I don't talk, say I love Nigeria, die. I will stand up any day, any time to defend and represent Nigeria to the fullest. So anytime, next time, if you don't ever steal Nigerians' money, if you don't ever do something, we hurt Nigeria. Next time patriotic Nigerians, them stand up, or them they sing, or them they recite the national pledge or the national anthem, shut the fuck up.